Howard Hopkins.
That's
the other half of Wii production.
Hi there.
Robbie Williams.
What do you do with that thing after the show?
Hey, JT, man.
The best.
Right now. Now look at this motley crew. Look at these guys. Okay, this is the team. This is part of the team.
So you're the lighting director?
I am the lighting director.
So what's the challenge in making a light show like this?
Having everybody hang around all the time.
Warning, run away.
Keyboard player.
Why have all the musicians got video recorders?
I'm having a great time.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
How far have you been with them?
I started with them last August.
Yeah?
I've been on the road a year.
What's the feeling about playing somewhere like this?
Look at that. Well, I've
Come
been.
On. Wouldn't the king have been Louis XIV been appalled at this sort of decadence?
No.
No?
I think this is right up his alley. That's the beauty of this entire concert. Yeah.
This is the most important part of the show. Smoke. Once you shoot it tonight, you'll see.
About your writing on the new LP, it seems that old undercurrent, Freud undercurrent of madness, of interest in madness.
I mean, it's not an obsession with madness particularly. I mean, I don't think there's anything particularly on the new album about madness, is there?
It strikes me that not so much madness, more depression.
Well, I
pointlessness of life almost.
Yes, well, that's something that I think about. I don't know, it's from a different angle than the way Roger wrote, but I don't know, maybe it's catching. So sometimes in my darker moments I ponder on those things and sometimes write about them.
Is that when you write, in your darker moments?
Often, yeah, because the darker emotions tend to be the more powerful ones. And it's hard to write a happy song.
How much effect did...
Except for John Denver.
...did Syd Barrett have on you? Because it strikes me you were the closest to him. You taught him a lot of the guitar playing.
We were friends from when we were 14. We went on holidays together in the south of France, and camping in tents and being arrested together on the front in Saint-Tropez for busking and all that.
When Syd Barrett left Pink Floyd in March 1968, bass player Roger Waters began to assume more and more control, culminating in 1979's extravaganza The Wall, Waters' thinly disguised psychological autobiography. After one further LP, 83's The Final Cut, Waters left the Stationary Band to pursue a solo career and continues to regard Pink Floyd as dissolved. He will be seeing the rest of his former colleagues in court later this year.
Life's too short to piss around with all that stuff, you know. My view on it is very simple, you know. I have a right to carry on doing my career. I've spent 20 years doing it, and I'm not going to have anyone tell me that I can't do it. And it's as simple as that. As long as I carry on doing it well, to the best of my ability, and the people still are willing to pay to come and see and listen and buy the records and stuff, then no one is going to prevent me from doing that.
We tend to favour a sort of style of performing that uses these sort of devices, these sort of montages of sound, which I still like. I mean, I know we've used them for years, and with hopefully there are new sounds that come in, but certainly it's an old idea. But I still find it a fascinating one.
What do you get out of a show like tonight, which is a special event on the tour? What will you get out of it emotionally?
Well, God, that's the million-dollar question, isn't it, really? What people get out of doing this for a living, I don't know. It's very good for the ego. It's good for the bank balance. And it's very sort of satisfying. I mean, it's a very immediate way of getting your creative rocks off, if you like. I mean, the old clichés are the only ones that really fit.